In this video I will show you how to create some basic models using Sweet Home 3D. In the first model I am going to show you how to make arched ceiling. Before we get started with the arched ceiling, we need to remove the flat ceiling that's already there. Double click anywhere on the room. Modify rooms, dialog box opens up, under the ceiling section. Uncheck the display ceiling checkbox. To make the arched ceiling, select the create wall tool. Left click once. Move the mouse until you have the desired width for the arched ceiling. Press and hold down the control key. And click again. Double click to end the wall. Double click on the long wall of your room. And copy the distance between end points. This is the length of your room. And paste it in the wall height for the arched ceiling. Click OK. This is it. The arched ceiling model. All that's left is to add color to it. You can also use texture. With the arched ceiling selected, click on 3D view and click on export to OBJ format. Save the object. And remember the location. Make sure to click export selection. Now that you have exported the model to OBJ, you can delete the arched wall. Go to furniture and click on import furniture and find the arched ceiling OBJ. Open it. Use the arrows to adjust the model. One click on the right arrow and one click on the top arrow will turn the ceiling the right way. Rotate and raise. Now I am going to fill in the openings around the ceiling. There are more than one way to do this. First, add a level. Create the walls around the ceiling. Another way would be to increase the height of the walls on the bottom level. Make sure you have display all levels selected in the 3D view. I'm going to show you another method to do this. First, delete the upstairs walls as well as the ceiling. Select the first level and copy it. Paste it onto the top level. Delete the door and the window. Drag the arched ceiling back. This time, there is no need to change the elevation, because it's already where it needs to be. If you look at the room ceiling from the ground level, you'll notice the flat ceiling is showing again. This is actually the upstairs floor. So, go to Level 1 and uncheck the display floor in the Modify Room dialog box. Now I am going to create the flat part of the ceiling for the left and the right side of the arched ceiling. With the Create Wall tool, make a wall the same length as the room. This part of the ceiling needs to be about 2 feet wide. So, I will change the wall height to 2 feet. We'll repeat the same process as we did with the arched ceiling. Apply the color or texture. Export to OBJ. And import. When importing, be sure to change the orientation using the arrows. You can use the same model for both sides of the room. Just copy. Paste. And use the arrow keys on the keyboard. Or the mouse to adjust it. Next, I'm going to show you how to create this arched door opening. Use the Create Wall tool to create the arch door shape. Change the wall height to whatever you want your arched door model thickness to be. I will make mine 3 inches, because that's the wall thickness by default. Once you have your arch door opening created, you can make whatever shapes in it you want, if any. Texture or color before exporting. Again, when importing, make sure to turn the model the right way. Make sure you check mark the door or window box. And the last model I will be showing you how to make today is the bay window. Remove the section of the wall where you want the window to be. Make the new wall in the shape you want your bay window to be. This time, I am going to use both texture and the color on the wall. The bottom portion of the wall is going to be brick. Top siding and the inside I will use two different colors. If you don't already have the window model, you can go to sweethome3d.com and download it. The model I got is too small. So I have to adjust the size. Place the windows onto the walls. After you have the texture, paint, and windows adjusted the way you want it to be, you are ready to export the OBJ. This time when importing, you don't have to change the orientation of the object, because it is already upright. I hope you enjoyed watching this video. See you next time.